Leisure travel, will it increase or decrease in the coming years?
Increase.
Well, it says on the slide, so. but logically, why do you think it's going to increase? Yes, ma'am.
With the social media aspect of our world, you can see where everyone's going, so you want to do that too.
Right. What's that called? FOMO?
Fear of missing out.
Yeah, FOMO. Fear of missing out. It's a true thing, right? Absolutely. Oh, that's cool. I mean, you know, we used to do it in the old days before the internet, but it was magazines. Oh, look at this cool place. Now it's all social media. Excellent. Okay, anything else? Let me give you some other statistics here. Oh, go ahead.
I was going to say, countries know that it's good to have tourism as part of their economy, so they'll try and, like, advertise more and more.
Incentivize travel. Yeah, absolutely. Because they know what you know now. The multiplier effect is good. And so we should be doing all we could to facilitate travel. Excellent. Well, not only that, people are living longer. Right? Lifespans are greater. So there's more opportunity to travel. Flexible working hours. I come from a time when I was young when everybody pretty much didn't do anything throughout the regular year, but in the summer that's when you did your travel. Maybe you took a week and on summer vacation or whatever, okay? That's just was the normal work schedule, okay? Now, you know, it's not Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. We work all kinds of different hours. And so, you know, there are opportunities to travel on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. It's not just the weekends anymore. And on top of that, there's a new phenomenon out there that we've seen develop in that people are not taking one 2-week vacation. They're splitting it up throughout the year, maybe 5-6, like half week or long weekend vacations. And, you know, again, the idea is let's not just go one place for 2 weeks. Let's go to 5 or 6 different places, you know, next year and split out our vacation. And we can do that because of flexible work hours, untraditional, non-seasonal type of travel that's available to us. Early retirement. Okay, people are getting wealthy and they're retiring earlier. And so they have money and they have their relative youth, let's call it. They're younger than, previous retirees. And so they're going out and seeing the world, right? You ever been driving down the interstate? You see this big old motorhome barreling down on you? Who's behind the wheel? Yeah, Grandpa, right? Yeah, me and Grandma are going out to see the world, right? We're going out to Utah, or we're going to the Grand Canyon, right? They've got the money, and they've got the longer lifespan, so they're getting out and traveling. Greater ease of travel. I still hate flying anymore. I used to love to fly. I can remember a time before September 11th, I showed at the airport like 15 minutes before my flight, I walked right on. Now you got to get there 2 hours in advance, and the TSA is really a hassle, so it kind of balances out. But, you know, I tell you what, if you're older, you absolutely want to fly, because if you ever been in like the airport and you hear this beep, beep, beep as you're walking to your terminal behind you, what is it?
Shuttle.
It's the shuttle for who? All the old people, right? They pick you right up at the gate and take you on the golf cart and put you right on the plane first. Man, if you want to travel, get old, because they take really good care of you. Me, I'm like fighting through, you know, flight attendants and crowds or whatever. But when you hear that beep, beep, you better get out of the way, because they will run you over. All right? And again, like I said, we're taking shorter, more frequent trips. We're still taking our 14 days of vacation. We're breaking it up, which is actually good. And again, I won't go into the deep economics of it, but you.